Jesus, call God his father. When I go to the Quran, Muhammad never called God father.
Never.
People don't concern. It's only Muslims who don't concern. No remorse, no regret, no repentance to be part of the society.
Let Muhammad brought.
Let Muhammad is telling.
Leave Muhammad alone.
Yeah. Let Muhammad
alone.
It's Muhammad.
Yet Muhammad rejected Jesus as his savior. That's a choice. Without Jesus Christ, we cannot have true peace. Because the truth sets you free from the lie. There's no greater love.
La ilaha
illallah.
Muhammad Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Love. Joy, peace,
long-suffering,
mercy, kindness, gentleness, self-control.
Who's go, go, ya donkey.
What is that about
Kalbi, ya Bahayim?
Do on our own.
Go donkey and the Trump donkey. And Obama donkey.
Who sent Jesus Christ as the savior of the world? When he died and rose again, he sent his spirit to live and those who would receive him as their savior.
Why I am the Lord, and besides me, there is no savior. Besides me, there is no savior. But today, these people say, Jesus is the savior. Jesus is the savior. Where do you get that from? They come, they get that concept from Paul. Paul says that in the book of Philippians 2:10, that in the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and on the earth. We are telling you, we are following Paul, the fake Paul. You are not following Jesus. Jesus was the prophet, the Messiah,
Allah says,
sent to the children of Israel.
Paul is a mighty messenger.
Let me finish talking, please. Don't interrupt.
God.
You read the Bible again in the book of Exodus. In the book of Exodus.
This guy.
No, hang on. Don't interrupt the debate. Don't interrupt the debate. Stay there and listen.
In the book of Exodus,
stay there and
chapter
listen.
Number 9, verse number 14. God said, God is talking. That you may know that there is none like me in all the earth. None like me. It was the quote of the glorious Quran. That agrees with the glorious Quran. The concept of God in the glorious Quran, we go to Surah Ikhlas. Quran has got 114 surahs. Surah Ikhlas is 112 surahs. If you want to know about the concept of God, Surah Ikhlas. Surah Ikhlas says, Kul huwallahu ahad. Says Allah the one. Allah Samad. Allah upon whom all depend. He begets not. No, he's the begotten. And there is nothing unto like him. Nothing unto like him. Go to the Bible. And you go Isaiah chapter 46, verse number 9. God said, remember the former things of old, for I am God, and there is no other. I am God, and there is none like me. Lam yakullahu kufuwan ahad. You are fallen God.
Have you finished? Have you finished?
Go on, 3 minutes. Go on, 3 minutes.
Never finished.
Ladies and gentlemen, the man talked about John chapter 14, and he was going in something different. He's quoting scripture that he has got no idea of. We are dealing with John chapter 14. Jesus said in verse 2, in my Father's house, there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have not told you. I go there to prepare a place for you in my Father's house. Who on earth can call God the Creator his Father? The prophet could not call God his Father. No messengers have the audacity to call the Creator Almighty God their Father. How come it was only Jesus who called God the Father as his Father? And not only that, when we go to the book of Isaiah, it is written, Isaiah 53, he said, and to us a son is born. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace, Everlasting Father, Almighty God. Not only that, Jesus called God his father. When I go to the Quran, Muhammad never called God father.
Never.
Muhammad will call my God. Moses. Did Moses, one of the greatest prophets, did he ever call God father? No. Did Elijah call God father? No. Did Jeremiah call God father? No. How come it is Jesus only who can call God his father? Not only that, can you compare Jesus, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel the same? They are never the same. Isaiah had a father, Moses had a father, Elijah had a father, but Jesus did not have a father. If I have to notify this Muslim man in his book, whether Hadith or the Quran is written, that Isa, the son of Maryam, was taken up by Allah and is coming back. The whole of Muslim all over the world, they believe that Jesus is coming back. Why can't they believe in Muhammad or Moses or Jeremiah that they are coming back? Why is it that Jesus coming back? Not only that, hang on, Jesus didn't have a physical father like you and I. Jesus did more miracles than any prophet that ever lived on earth. Not only that, Jesus ascended up in heaven and he's gonna come back in the same like manner. That indicates that Jesus is more than a prophet, is more than a messenger, is more than a man. He is the Son of God. When he was crucified, you know what happened? The veil of the temple was torn to pieces. And the saints who died, they were resurrected and they were, hang on, sir, they were taken up in heaven. Not only that, when in the Garden of Gethsemane, you know, the Father sent Elijah and Moses, they appeared to Jesus. His disciples, they saw those men. He said, "This is my son, in whom I am well pleased." God testify before the ears of men that Jesus was his son. Even in River Jordan, when Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist, the Bible says the heaven was open and the Father spoke, hang on, "This is my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased." It is in the Bible. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Wasted, I mean, wasted.
He hasn't read the Bible.
Oh, yes, I know.
We the Muslims, we believe in Jesus Christ. We love
you. Don't believe in Jesus.
We believe in his heart.
Jesus, we believe in Jesus as a man, the Messiah sent to the children of Israel. He never said worship him, never said he was God. They are following the church and Paul. Now, if Jesus is Almighty God, why is Jesus calling God by God and praying to God? For example, another one here. According to Bible, in the Gospel of Matthew, Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 27, verse number 46, Matthew 27, 46. According to them, when Jesus was being crucified, he cried aloud, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?" You're not listening. We're debating. You're not listening. You're not there. No, look. You're not. It's digressing now. No.
Same rhetoric.
He's escaping.
Same rhetoric.
He wants to run away. Don't. He's not coming. Come on.
Yeah?
Same rhetoric. He's escaping.
We don't throw pearls to swine, bro.
Expose him. See? You see now?
Benito.
Hey, see now, someone came to his rescue. Thank you very much for accepting. Which Bible? Thank you very much for accepting. Which Bible? 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 Which Bible
when Muhammad is saying that Satan cast false revelation on my mouth. Then how can this foolish Muslim will say this is not true?
These Christians are a disgrace. Why? These Christians,
ladies and gentlemen, don't be deceived, this foolish man.
These Christians are a disgrace. Why? They are confused. These Christians, they are not speak.
I have a satanic version in me. How can this foolish man deceive innocent people?
They just come out of the jungle. Mr. Shaitan, hey, why are you drinking water? He's got to have a heart attack.
This is the pure water. Let me give you
liar.
Let me give you an example. As this pure water, if somebody is putting 2 drops of poison in that, will this water be able to drink? No, nobody will drink it. Same is with the Quran. When Quran,
it's too much for you.
When Quran is saying that I have a satanic person in me, when Hadith is saying I have a satanic person, Surah 53 verse 19, Surah 53 verse 19, Lat, Munat and Uzzat. They are the three daughters of Allah. They are the three daughters of Allah, which Muhammad bought before, which Muslim bought before.
Have I read?
He is the false prophet. He is the false prophet. He is the false prophet. We can't let him.
You call women dogs.
He is a false prophet. Any revelation which is brought by itself, and it is not said by Allah or said by God, that is a false prophet. Allah Akbar! Oh, who is a pagan?
You are.
Allah is a pagan.
You
are proving that. You are proving that is a pagan God.
Is it pagan?
That is how ISIS. That is how ISIS are chanting all the time.
You are like ISIS.
That is how ISIS are chanting all the time. Whenever they kill innocent people, they chant like you. They chant like you. That's why we are saying.
You are a Hindu.
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
That's ISIS. That's a fruit of Islam. That's a filthy fruit of Islam. That's a filthy fruit of Islam. We can see it clearly. We can see it clearly. That's the filthy fruit of Islam in England even. In England. Let alone in Iraq and any other places. But the filthy fruit are here in England even. So ladies and gentlemen, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived by false revelation. Don't be deceived. Muhammad is telling that Satan caused false revelation on my mouth. So Satan caused false revelation on my mouth. Ladies and gentlemen, how can that Prophet Mia Ru Prophet, who is bringing a false revelation? Who is bringing a false revelation? How can that God, that prophet be a true prophet? How can that prophet be a true prophet? Who is bringing? We have proved it. Sahih Muslim is proving. Sahih Bukhari is proving. Quran is proving. That Satan caused false revelation on Muhammad's mouth.
That's the best you can do.
What else?
Moral.
What else you want?
No manners.
No, no, what no. else you want?
Give us reference.
What else you want? The whole world. The whole world knows that Quran has a satanic verses, and Quran himself says, I have been abrogated every now and then. I'm abrogated from every now and then.
How long have you been Christian?
It's in the Bible.
Leave Christianity alone and leave Islam. Go back to the
Quran. Where are the world to come?
Who is he speaking about? So it's, I don't know the exact wording, but basically he says,
if you don't know, why are you bringing this fine?
I can get it for you.
No. Why are you bringing this fine if you don't know?
Because I know the important words. There are many things I have to say unto you now, but you cannot bear them, for he when the spirit of truth shall come, he will glorify me.
Okay, spirit of truth.
Who is the spirit of truth?
Who is the spirit of truth?
Who glorifies Jesus?
Okay.
You read the Quran.
Jesus is saying, I'm going away, and I will send that spirit of truth. I'm sending the spirit of truth. So Jesus is talking about the Holy Spirit. Jesus is talking about the Holy Spirit. So Holy Spirit, when all the disciples, they were gathered in an upper room, they received the Holy Spirit. And that what Jesus is telling them, that I'm going to give you that authority, which authority I had authority to raise the dead.
How long have
I had the authority to heal the sick?
How long have you been
the authority to?
You have very little knowledge. How long have you been Christian? How long have you been Christian?
Oh, thank God. Thank God.
You've only been Christian a weekend.
Whatever the knowledge I have, whatever the...
Yeah, you've got no knowledge.
Huh?
The Holy Spirit was
at least, there. At least I have a knowledge to bring my Jesus.
You probably have more knowledge of Hinduism.
I'm bringing the honor.
You're
my Jesus. I'm bringing the honor.
You're only a Christian
for
a few years.
My
you have
Jesus
no knowledge.
Is honor.
Okay, so it's just the Holy Spirit in the Bible. Yeah?
That's right.
So why does it say the Spirit of Truth and not the Holy Spirit?
Huh?
So why in that verse does it say the Spirit of Truth and not the Holy Spirit?
That's for God. Who is the Spirit of Truth?
Asking me if it's Sina. Asking me if it's Sina. Will be called a Spirit of Truth.
Which Bible?
Which
Bible?
Can you prove who's the sinner?
Yeah, Muhammad from the Quran.
Which Bible?
Muhammad had a sex with Maria.
Sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Maria, which was a slave.
He's weak.
Which was a slave girl. Which was a slave girl. When Aisha and Safiya. When Aisha and Safiya, they ask about Muhammad and ask Muhammad, did you have a sex with Maria? Did you have a sex with Maria? Muhammad said, no. I had no sex with Maria. Okay, no. When they removed their shoes and started beating Muhammad.
What is
when they started beating Muhammad? Okay. No, Aisha. Met Aisha and Safiya.
Aisha,
they beat her.
You drink too much. You don't know yourself.
What has that got to do with his question?
Shoes.
It's not intelligent.
So this is what I'm saying. Muhammad is telling lies.
That's your interpretation.
Muhammad is telling lies about the sex with the slave girl.
Can you show me where that is? Can you show me where that is?
You can read Sahih Bukhari. You can read Quran.
Okay.
Yeah. Even yeah. Not only that, but when Muhammad is went to his son's house and he saw the daughter-in-law naked, and he then came back. Yeah,
and his heart was filled with the love of
his daughter-in-law, isn't it?
Daughter-in-law. Yeah. Yeah. And then next day, he said to his son, you divorce.
47:19.
Muhammad, so if he sinned, he had to forgive for it. None has the right to be worshipped but Allah, and ask forgiveness for your sin, and also for the sin of believing men and believing women. And Allah knows well your moving about and your place of rest in your homes.
Yeah. Okay, so in the same respect as to Muhammad asking for forgiveness, yeah?
So, he's doing it, so who is the spirit of truth? Just quickly, I'll address this one, and then we'll go...
Yeah, in response to that.
So basically with this, right, he's actually got to do everything as an example to us. He needs to show us how to live. So I ask for forgiveness many times a day, because the Prophet, peace be upon him, did it 70 times a day. In the same respect that when you talk about Jesus and him praying, you would say he only prayed as an example to us. So that's kind of a null point. You have the exact same principle.
But your question was the spirit of truth.
The spirit of truth. I just want to know who the spirit of truth is.
When Muhammad is asking for forgiveness of his sin which he has done now and in past
and future
and in future
and in future
in future past and present.
Sure.
So how can that prophet be sinless?
He is going to sin.
Exactly. And the spirit of truth, how can he be a spirit of truth?
Yeah, that's a good question. How can he be a spirit of truth if he's a sinner?
Because truth doesn't mean not sinning.
Exactly.
Truth means not
truth
lying.
Truth, he's a sinner, so lying is a sin.
Yeah, lying is a sin. Yeah?
Yeah,
he lied about Maria.
Satanic verses, he lied about that, for example. Satan put verses on his mouth, and then he recited
in the Bible, it
and then he said
Satan
that Satan put his mouth,
himself,
put those verses in his mouth. So he was deceived by Satan, though. So he lied.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
So what verse was it? I was just short. Oh, I hit Bob
there.
Muhammad cannot be the spirit of truth.
No. He's not.
I'm only glad being here. I'm not faced, but she says enemy of Islam, hence their head is separated from their body, is in the pain. Yes. You said you already read the article. Someone, she's 19 years old, shows no remorse, no regret. Are you concerned for every non-Muslims in this country when she comes back? Because she's British, at one point she's gonna come back. I'm concerned for this gentleman. But as a Muslim, you have no concerns, and you already told me you've got 9 years old child, and you feel safe for your child, yet I don't.
If she does come back, how should we get how should we get threat?
So let
can you quantify her?
Suppose
the government lets her in tomorrow. How should we be a threat to the people?
Okay. So, sir, do you think is it good environment when someone identifies non-Muslims as the enemy of Islam? And while the Islamic teaching tells us what should be done to the enemy of Islam, would you feel that's a good environment? Would you feel that's safe? No.
Well, she said the Muslims in the UK.
Sir, let me phrase that again. An ideology directly calls non-believers to be killed. An ideology called Islam. That ideology called peace. It is that peaceful. peace can only happen when every non-Muslim is out of life. I would concern for every non-Muslim when someone who sees the head of non-Muslims in the beach, have no regret, I'm not face of it, they are enemy of Islam.
Going back to the ideology, where do you get the ideology of Islam?
I get the ideology of Islam from the book called Quran and from man called Muhammad. Yeah. So, I can Quran? See you want to change the topic.
No, but you said it, I didn't say it.
Can you just...
I'm just trying to refute
you. Can you just join me and express my concerns for every non-Muslim in Britain when people follow ideology of Islam who were part of the ISIS comes back to this country?
That's a matter for the government. I'm not
the security services. That's a matter for the government. As a citizen, do you pay tax? You do pay tax. So you are quite happy for your tax money to look after that woman and then look after her child. So now you're happy for your tax money.
Happy for my tax.
Instead of your quotas, your beans.
To me, it seems that people want to actually waste taxpayers' money to run the opposition down. It seems much like that. If you can just, you know, let the taxpayers pay for this, just let the government watch them. Who pays for that? Well, if you've got an ideology that wants to run down an opposition, that's one way to do it.
I do concern for someone who shows no remorse, no regret, and no repentance, to be part of the society.
Anyone who doesn't show remorse for a
certainly concern. People do concern. It's only Muslims who don't concern. No remorse, no regret, no repentance to be part of the society.
What she says.
Disturbing does not mean that you are.
Then
she said, I do not regret coming here.
But she knew what ISIS was doing. She knew what ISIS was doing, and yet she went out there. She knew they were beheading people. And she joined that. She joined that. I don't think she should come back.
She is along lots of hundreds of people, and people are coming back.
There are people from all faiths, from all countries.
Not all faiths, sir. I haven't seen Christians went there to fight with ISIS. I haven't seen that. Because Christian scripture doesn't teach that, sir. But I have seen people who claim to follow religion called Islam to went and fight with ISIS.
How many Muslims do you know? How many Muslims do you know?
Clearly more than you.
How many Muslims are there?
That's different topic.
That's
different topic. Sir, we already heard people's claim about it.
What happened to her?
So did you get rid of your Quran? So if you didn't get rid of your Quran, then you need to follow your Quran and the teachings of your Quran. And you've got young lovely girls who stand by the teachings of Islam.
In the event of war, in self-defense, yes.
When you can
be killed, that's normal in the war.
Okay, can you tell me what war was happening in Surah 929 and 930? So, let's look at the context. What war was happening in Surah 929 and 930? Okay?
You're telling me you don't want to find the Surah.
I'm going to read it for you.
Somebody comes to kill you.
Do
you know how many Muslims died there by Christians?
Do
you know that?
Lord, the last day.
In Balkan, how many Muslims died by Christians?
I don't know that.
You know,
sir, do you believe in Allah?
No.
No, I don't believe in Allah.
Allah is only a word for God.
Fight those who do not believe in Allah. Sir, do you believe in Allah?
The Quran says that Jesus would descend from heaven and the child, the Antichrist, would dissolve like
stone.
Why is Muhammad coming? Why Jesus?
It's a good question.
Why is Muhammad dead in the grave? Rotting like the false prophet is. Why doesn't Allah send Muhammad to judge the world? Because Muhammad is dead. Muhammad
is gone. He will be judged as a false prophet by my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He will be judged for leading 1.8 people astray by offering them all the carnal desires of their heart.
He said, I am only the
messenger. This man is obedient. He's obedient to him. He got no answers for the truth.
Wait,
you want to listen to him?
You know he's true.
Who's going to judge the world? Who's going to judge the world?
Allah.
Who's going to judge the world?
Allah. Wait, listen to him. He asked a question.
Who's going to judge the world? Who is going to judge the world according to your Quran? See, he won't answer
because he knows his Jesus.
He knows his Jesus. Allah wants in Muhammad because Muhammad's rotting in his grave. That's why.
All the time we ask questions, now we just
believe in Jesus Christ. The sinless one.
You should be
giving him chance. You don't want to be a false prophet. We got no idea.
You want to follow the truth, but you not follow the truth.
Yeah, follow Jesus.
You not follow the truth.
Your guy Muhammad, like even a wicked man. And I'm glad he's dead. You know why? Because your Quran is bigger than my God, Jesus Christ. Muhammad in his stupidity wrote in your own Quran that Jesus will judge the world. That Jesus will descend from heaven. That Jesus is the sinless one. That Jesus is the one true living God. The word of God. The spirit of God. Hallelujah. God bless everybody. God bless everybody. Look in your Quran. Look in your Quran. Find the light.
That's what you need to do.
Amen.
Check Quran.
Amen.
Recite.